As you all know, few students are getting some problem. So today I am discussing 8-bit logical instructions once again. So everybody focus for today's class. Our first instructions for today's class is ANR. ANA basically represent to AND gate, or you can say it perform the ANDing operation. As you all know, what is AND gate? What is the truth table of AND gate? Okay, can you tell me for which input combination output of AND gate is high? I think you have studied about AND gate. Can you tell me? My question is, for which input combination output of AND gate is high always?
सर अगर इनपुट सर दोनों इनपुट हाई होंगे तो
एग्जैक्टली व्हेन बोथ द इनपुट्स आर हाई इन दैट केस द आउटपुट ऑफ द एंड गेट विल रिमेन हाई. ओके, एन आर, दिस आर इज रिप्रेजेंट अ रजिस्टर, वेदर इट इज रजिस्टर ए बी सी डी ई एच और एल. इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द इंस्ट्रक्शन वर्ड साइज ऑफ एन आर, इट इज ऑफ 1 byte. Now come to the operation. What is the operation performed by ANAR instruction? We already discussed it perform ANDing operation. That means the content of register R is ANDed with the content of accumulator. And after ANDing operation, result will always be stored in accumulator by default. So this is the expression for operation of ANAR instruction. Content of A is ANDed with the content of R. The result will be stored into accumulator. Okay, now come to the addressing mode. For addressing mode, we have two case. If the this R is replaced by any one of register A, B, C, D, E, H, L, in that case, register addressing mode is possible. If this R is replaced by memory, or you can say this R is replaced by M, this become case two. In that case, register indirect addressing mode is possible. Okay, if data is transferred or accessing from register, in that case register addressing mode. If data is accessing from memory, it become a register indirect addressing mode. Okay, this is the example for ANDing operation. Suppose you have one data in register A, that is 0101, and the last nibble is 1001, and the second data is available in register R, that is 1000 and 4 times 0, last nibble 4 times 0. Now we are going to perform this instruction ANAR. What is the function of ANAR? It basically what it do, the content of register R is ANDed with the content of A. So now here we are performing this instruction. After execution of this instruction, the content of register A and register R will be ANDed. So after performing ANDing operation, we get this type of result into register A. Okay, any doubt? If you have any doubt, you can ask beta. Are you getting my point? How ANAR instruction works? Still, if you have any doubt, you can ask. Okay, so the final result is 00 into accumulator. Now come to the second instruction, that is ANI 8-bit data. Okay, the IWS for this instruction is 2 byte. How it is 2 byte? 1 byte for this 8-bit data and 1 byte for ANI. Okay, so 1 plus 1, it become a 2 byte. If you talk about the operation, what operation performed by this ANI 8-bit data? This 8-bit data is ANDed with the content of accumulator, and after AND operation, in between content of 8-bit data and content of accumulator, and the result will be stored into accumulator. You can see here, this 8-bit data is ANDed with the content of accumulator, and after ANDing operation, result will be stored into accumulator. As we all know, here the last letter in instruction is I, so this become an immediate addressing mode. Okay, this is, you all know, we already discussed that addressing mode. Now come to the one question or one problem. If you have one problem, MVI A, 26H, MVI B, FFH, and the next statement is ANA B. So what will be the content of A and B after the execution of this assembly language program? So let's discuss one by one. After the execution of first statement, what will happen? MVI A, 26H, that means this 26 is immediately moved into the accumulator. So after execution of first statement, this will happen. 26 transferred into accumulator. And after the execution of second statement, MVI B, FFH, the FF is stored into register B. And the third statement is ANA B. It performs and operation in between content of register B and the content of register A. So this is the representation, how it works. And after ending operation, we get some result. So after execution of first and second statement, we have a data in register A and register B like this. Now we are writing it into binary formats. So A is having this data, and B, if we are writing, because this is in hex representation, and now we are writing into it in binary format. So this become 1111. So now we are performing ANDing operation. So after performing ANDing operation in between content of register A and the content of register B, we will get a result like this. And this can be represented. The first nibble in hexadecimal can be represented by 2, and the second 010110 in hexadecimal. Decimal. Okay. Now come to the third instruction. ORR. The size of IWS for this instruction is again 1 byte. Operation performed by ORR instruction is the content of A is added with the content of R, and the result will be stored into accumulator. Okay. Now come to the case one. If this register R is replaced by any one register out of this register A, B, C, D, E, H, L. In that case, register addressing mode is possible. If this R is replaced by memory, or you can say M, in that case, register indirect addressing mode is possible. Okay. Now come to the fourth instruction. Fourth instruction is OR I 8-bit data. IWS for this is 2 byte again, 1 byte for this 8-bit data, and 1 byte for OR RI. Okay. If you talk about the operation, what operation performed by this instruction? The 8-bit data is added with the content of accumulator. Okay. So this is the operation. You can see here, this is the operation performed by this instruction or function of this instruction. 8-bit data is added with the content of accumulator, and after addition, the result will be stored into accumulator by default. Okay, as we all know, the last letter in this instruction is I, so immediate addressing mode is possible, or you can say because data is immediately added or immediately ORing with the content of accumulator, that's why immediate addressing mode is exist for this instruction. Okay, any doubt till now? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now come to our next instruction, that is for XOR gate. Our fifth instruction for today's class, XRAR. IWS for this instruction is 1 byte instruction, and the operation performed by this is A XOR R. Or you can say the content of R register, the content of register R is XORed with the content of register A. Okay, you can say it basically perform an XOR operation in between the content of register R and register A, and register A is accumulator. एंड आफ्टर एक्सोरिंग ऑपरेशन रिजल्ट विल बी स्टोर्ड इनटू एक्यूमुलेटर. ओके नाउ कम टू द एड्रेसिंग मोड. फॉर दिस वी हैव अ केस वन एंड केस टू. इफ दिस आर इज रिप्लेस्ड बाय सम रजिस्टर अदर इट इज रजिस्टर ए बी सी डी ई एच एल इन दैट केस रजिस्टर एड्रेसिंग मोड इज पॉसिबल. इफ दिस R is replaced by memory, or you can say M. In that case, indirect register addressing mode is possible. Indirect register addressing mode or register indirect addressing mode, both are same. Okay. Any doubt in fifth instruction? Can we proceed?
Yes, sir.
My dear student, if you have any doubt, you can ask to me. Feel free to ask your doubts because it's a very important class, 8-bit logical instructions. You already studied about 8-bit logical instructions. For the sake of simplicity of the instructions, I'm covering it again. Still, if you have any doubt, you can contact or you can call, you can ask your doubt. Now, next instruction is XRI 8-bit data. IWS for this instruction is again 2-byte, 1-byte for this 8-bit data, and 1-byte for this XRI. Operation again, it perform XOR operation in between 8-bit data and the content of register A. Okay, and then result will be stored in accumulator by default. Okay, addressing mode, as you all know, the last letter is I, so the addressing mode possible in that in this case is immediate addressing mode is possible only. Okay, now we have some important note one. These all are instructions till now cover 214 sections. XNOR operation is not possible in it. Okay, sometime question asked in gate exam, in NAT exam, whether XNOR operation is possible or which instruction is used for XNOR operation. So please keep this note in your mind always. Don't forget this point. XNOR operation is not possible in it. Okay, now come to the next instruction, CMA. Basically perform the ones complement. You heard about ones complement, twos complement? You know ones complement?
Yes, sir.
In ones complement, what will happen? One is replaced by zero and zero is replaced by one. So this is all about ones complement. The IWS for this instruction is again 1-byte. The operation performed by this, if we have a A, the content of A is complemented. Okay. If we are having 100 in accumulator, if we are having any data 100 in accumulator, then complement of that data becomes 011. Okay, and addressing mode is implicit addressing mode is possible in this code, in this instruction, because opcode is complete in itself. That's why implicit addressing mode is possible. Now we have few important notes. Note one, CMA does not affect any flag. Okay. Note two, AND or XOR will reset carry flag whatever the previous value in it. Okay. Note three, AND operation set the IC flag. Sometime question asked in exam, which instruction set the auxiliary carry flag? So you will answer AND instruction set the AC flag. Next note four, OR XOR operation reset AC flag. Okay, don't forget all these. Now come to the problem. We have one problem, MVI A comma 23H, MVI B comma 32H, XRA B ADI 88H HURD. After the execution of this assembly language program, what will be the status of flag register? Okay, so this is a small problem for your homework, and in tomorrow's class I will check answer for this question in your notebook. Still, if you have any doubt, you can ask